سابقا تعلمنا الشدة or this sign it is سكون plus one of the حركات. As we said before, when we see this sign we will pronounce the letter twice or we will stress on the صوت because there are two letters but we merge them and we stress on the sound as we pronounce it twice. ثلاثة اثنان واحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. مرحبا جميعا. أنا عز الدين and this is Learn Arabic with Zed. كيف حالكم؟ كيف حالكم؟ كيف حالكم؟ No, not again. I told you I want you to reply out loud. There is someone who is watching the video. I didn't hear his voice. Okay, now we can start. Don't forget again. You will reply مرحبا and you will answer my question كيف حالكم. You will say أنا بخير. Then you will ask me وأنت. So I can tell you أنا بخير. اليوم I want you to imagine with me that the 28 letters in the Arabic alphabets, they decided to divide themselves into two groups. Why? He said sometimes you are playing football, so we need to make two teams. So they decided the two teams of the alphabets football team. Yes, yes, yes. In alphabets football, they are playing 14 against 14. It's just you don't know it because you don't watch the alphabet football. Well, then they asked themselves, how will the fans differentiate between the two teams? No, of course no. Alphabets, they are not wearing jerseys. So how can you think that they will differentiate between the two teams with different color of jerseys? Do you know how they will do that? I don't know actually. They went to Al to help them in doing that because Al is the definite article as we learned before. Then Al said, I am the definite article. So both of you need to pronounce me in different way. To distinguish yourself, yes, you will use me. One of the team accepted the idea, but the other team, they said, no, we don't accept that. And also you not pronounce the whole of Al. You just pronounce A. Oh, now we have another problem. Wait, now they are different. This is what we were looking for. So now we have two teams. One of the teams decided to pronounce Al, one decided not to pronounce Al. Then they were looking for names for their teams. Then they saw the sun and the moon. One of the teams said we are lunar alphabets and the other said we are solar alphabets. And to use Al, the first team named their team the alphabets of lunar Al. The other team named themselves the alphabets of solar Al. Actually, I don't know why these names, but really in Arabic, these alphabets, we call them the alphabets of Al Al-Qamariya, which means lunar Al, and the other group of alphabets, their name is alphabets of Al Al-Shamsiya, alphabets of solar Al. Okay, what is the difference between them? For now, let's say we have a blue group and red group to make it easier. So the blue group decided if they come after Al in any word, they will pronounce Al, the definite article. And the other group, they decided if they came after Al in a word, they will not pronounce the whole Al, they will just pronounce A. And just as more accessories, they said we will use Shadda also. Are you confused? With examples, everything being easier. Well, let's start with the name itself. Al-Qamar and Al-Shams, the moon and the sun. So if Qa came after Al, we will pronounce Al clearly. We will say Al-Qamar. On the other hand, if Sha, one of the other team, came after Al, we will not pronounce Al clearly. We will just pronounce A. We will say Ash-Shams, Ash-Shams. And we will put Shadda on Sha, so we will stress on Sha, Ash-Shams. Another example, if Mu came and it is one of the lunar Al team, Al Al-Qamariya, we will pronounce Al. We will say Al-Mu'allim, Al-Mu'allim. But if Da came and it's one of the solar Al alphabets, Al Shamsiya, we will pronounce the word Ad-Darraja, Ad-Darraja. We will not pronounce La, we will only pronounce A. And as we said, we will put Shadda on Da, so we will have double sawt, or we will stress on the sawt. Ad-Darraja, Ad-Darraja. Another example, Ki is one of the alphabets of Al Al-Qamariya, the lunar Al, so we will pronounce it Al-Kitab, Al-Kitab. On the other hand, we have Sa is one of the alphabets of Al Shamsiya, the solar Al, so we pronounce it As-Sayyara, As-Sayyara. Another example, we have B is one of the blue team or the team of alphabets of Al Al-Qamariya, so we'll pronounce the word Al-Bind, البند. But if we have two and it's one of the alphabets of theme of ال الشمسية, so we'll pronounce the word التفاحة. التفاحة. We will not pronounce لا. It's not ال, it is ات. And it's that simple. So if you found any of these letters after ال, the definite article, you will not pronounce لا and you will put شد on the letter. But if you found one of these letters after ال, the definite article, you will pronounce ال clearly and you will not put شد on the letter. And as a hint, to know whether you will read it with clear ال or only A, if you found شد on the letter, you will not pronounce لا, you will just pronounce A. If you didn't find شد on the letter, so you'll pronounce the previous ال clearly. See? ببساطة. Simple. ببساطة. Now in these examples, I want you to read the word before I do, and I want you to know when you will read ال clearly and when you won't read ال clearly. And I want you to figure out whether the word is one of the alphabets of ال القمرية, the alphabets of lunar ال, or the alphabets of ال الشمسية, the alphabets of solar ال. The most important thing, concentrate here. So if you find شده, you will stress this letter and you will not pronounce لا. If you didn't find شده, you will pronounce the ال clearly. From now you can pause the video if you want more time to think. Now think in this first one. How will you pronounce it? Now I will answer. It is الولد and it's one of the lunar ال alphabets. ال القمرية. Second word. Again, concentrate on this sign. شده. So how will you pronounce this word? And it is from which theme? ال القمرية or ال الشمسية? The lunar ال or the solar ال? Think. Now I will answer. It is السمكة. السمكة. Because we have شده, we will not pronounce لا and it's theme of ال الشمسية. The solar ال. Now you are on your own. Think. Pronounce the word. Answer out loud. And decide whether this letter is one of the ال القمرية team or ال الشمسية team. The lunar ال team or the solar ال team. This is the first word. You can pause if you want to think. Okay, the answer is it's with the lunar ال team. There is no شده above A and we pronounce it ال أسد. ال أسد. Next word. You can think. Well, it is again one of the alphabets of ال القمرية, the lunar ال, and we pronounce it القلب. القلب. There is no شده here above قا. Last word we have. Think. Pause if you want to think more. It is one of the solar ال alphabets. We pronounce it السفينة. السفينة. We don't pronounce لا. And there's شدة above سا. So by now you can notice that the example which I gave before two lessons, when I pronounced السيارة, I just pronounced it ال because I was explaining the definite article rule. So it was wrong. We should pronounce it السيارة. Not السيارة. It is السيارة because سا. One of the solar ال letters. ال الشمسية, one of the letters of ال الشمسية. Now, from this lesson, I want you to understand that we have 14 letters. If they came after ال, we pronounce ال clearly. And there are other 14 letters. If they came after ال, we don't pronounce ال. We pronounce only A. And then we stress on the letter when we pronounce it because we put شده on it. And this is only when it is ال, the definite article, not if ال came in normal word, just as any letters. So when you hear someone saying السيارة, for example, it's easy, you will write السيارة, but it's not pronounced. And if you found it written in front of you, you will pronounce it ال. If there is no شده on the letter which is after ال, if there is شده, you will not pronounce it. And that's all for today. Looking forward to see you in the next video. See you soon. إلى اللقاء.